There's our address. This is the front door. This is our kitchen table mostly. We use this for special occasions like when somebody has a birthday, like my sister or me or somebody. This door we don't really mainly use. It's just there. It was there when we got there. We have an entertainment center. We have a computer over here, which is, we got it in like 99. This is our door out to the deck, and that's our garage. And there's my sister. In here is my bedroom. I like to play with my Nintendo 64. Sometimes we listen to music on my radio. Mainly sometimes I just go out here to go in here to have fun, and sometimes I just come in here to go to bed.
So Brandon, what do you think it's going to be like in 20 or 50 years for paper boys?
I think that there probably might be a paper boy, I don't know. Because they might find out of defying gravity, and then there'd be like cars that would be in air. So I don't know, that's kind of hard to tell. I think it'd be cool to have a car that could float in the air, because then I think it'd be cool. Because I've always wanted to know what it would be like to fly and float in the air. I think that in 50 years, the paper boys would probably have their own system where you can just deliver to the houses by mail or something like that.
What kind of music do you listen to?
Usually like rap, like Dr. Dre. Insane Down Posse. Those kind of songs are really awesome. I like the bass. That's what I like the most about it. And my mom's got good bass in her car, and it jiggles all over, and it can make the windows vibrate. I've lived in two different apartments in my life, and then I've lived in a trailer house, so that was interesting.
What's your dad like?
He's not very tall. He's fun. He bought me this motorcycle. He doesn't expect anything from me. He just expects me to do what I can, and if I can't do that, then that's fine. Just give it all that you can, and if you don't do a good job, that's fine. He doesn't put any people down. He's a good person, and I think that's good.
Hey, Brandon, you want to have a race?
Yeah?
I can have a race.
I think it's very good for him to have a job. Get some responsibility to him, right?
Mm-hmm.
Learn what money is about, how to spend it, right? Did you get any of these, Brandon? I didn't watch as much TV as Brandon does.
Yeah.
I think there's a lot of good channels, a lot of good shows on TV for kids. But it does seem to take up a lot of their time. There was a lot more outdoor activities when we were younger. And that was part of what we like to do, see Brandon. He does get to play outside quite a bit with the neighborhood kids. And see that he does be able to keep a job and know that there's more to life than just sitting in front of the TV.
So Brandon, do you save your money or do you spend it?
I usually save it and buy something big.
Like what?
Like I bought that bike over there.
How much was it?
About $150, but it wasn't brand new. And the guy who sold me it said if it was brand new, it'd be about $300. You have to make sure that your list is correct, and you have to go over it about every day. You have to make sure that it gets there, and so that when you throw it, it doesn't go off to the side and get into the bushes or something. Working hard is important because it shows that you're actually doing a good job and you're not slacking, and you're showing good customer service, and that's what they like. They like to see that you work hard.
This is my bed, and this is my brother's bed right here. We used to have a TV right here, but we got rid of that. Well, good kids don't break the law. Good kids clean up their room. Good kids listen to their parents. Good kids obey adults. Good kids listen to their teachers and don't, like, be bad to them or something. Bad kids break the law. Bad kids are really mean. Bad kids, like, don't listen to their teachers. They, like, sass their parents and stuff.
Do you know any bad kids?
Quite a few.
What are they like? Tell me stories about them.
I know one kid, he deals drugs and he smokes the marijuana. And I know a whole bunch of other kids who, like, smoke cigarettes and stuff and drink alcohol. And
what kind of kid are you, do you think?
Kind of in between. Because, like, I sometimes shoot off fireworks, but they're just, like, sparklers and just little fireworks just for the 4th of July, you know. Usually people do that, and I'm probably kind of in between. I'd say I'm pretty good, though, usually. Hopefully.
Let's put this up here, Jeremy.
Okay. Wait, let's get more something like grass.
Okay. Here. Here, I got it. Wait, we gotta move it back a little bit.
Hey, why don't we just put it over there?
Well, no, let's keep it here because it's easier. Kind of want to be like a carpenter or a veterinarian or a landscaper like my dad is. Yeah. Oh, it's got a knot, I think.
How do you think the future's gonna be different than the world is today? Do you think there'll still be paper boys?
Well,
there might be
to take it over. Yeah, there might be some like machine or tube that goes to each house. And, like, they have tubes underground or something, and they slide them up, and they go all around, and they make them so they go to the house, and they open it up, and then they take their paper out or something. But they might still have paper boys. Either there's going to be less people or more people coming here to build their houses, or it's going to, like, completely be gone, maybe, which I hope it won't. I hope that a lot of the old houses that I kind of knew were around here will still be here when I become like, well, when I get older and like I have kids so I can show my kids where I used to live.
And so you can come back and visit.
Yeah, and so I can come back and visit people that I know.
Do you think it's important to work hard or?
Yeah, I think it is because if you don't, then it's just kind of like, okay, why aren't you doing anything? You should be doing something.
Well, they pick up the first, you know, they get all the papers ready at the office, you know, they wrap them. No, they don't really wrap them there. They just put them in this big case and they chuck them out their car window to the house. And sometimes it's so funny how they chuck it. They just whip it most of the time. But I hate it when it's wet out. They gotta bang. But they used to have these other bags that I liked a bit better because they're thin bags and you'd have to slide the paper in. It was a lot. Well, it was hard to bag them, but I liked those ones better. Of course, all dogs hate me on my paper. I mean, all of them bark at me.
Yeah.
Well, I think there's only one dog out of like, I don't know, 10 dogs that's kind. Well, my favorite band, I'd have to say is I like wrestlers' entrance themes. So I got like a couple of the, what do they call them, the entrance theme CDs. Did you see them in my room?
Yeah.
Over there? Yeah, there was my favorite band of all those is Triple H's music. My Time is what it's called.
Yo, tell me whose time it is now. Yeah, just kicking it up here. It's our time. Yo, here comes trouble.
Only on the Wednesdays, because you have to deliver the extras, and it pulls on your neck, and I guess you gotta work out your neck muscles more when you're working out at, like, a gym or something. Huh. But there are some times when I just wish I could say no more, but you gotta continue with your route. And even through rain and snow, I've hated the snow especially. The rain just, like, a lot of worms come up, but worms don't bother you. I mean, the snow is, when it was snowing, what I hated it the most. No more paper boys. I don't know if it'd be good or bad. In a way, it'd be good, in a way, it'd be bad, because one thing, you'd have to do less work, but then again, it'd be more people just sitting at home. I mean, it's good to get your exercise. I mean, you don't want to always sit at home. Probably 60% of America's population are overweight people, probably even more. I mean, that just shows that a lot of people need exercise, and if there was no more paper boys, then a lot of people would be, like, really obese, I guess.
Do you think knowing about tradition is important?
Kinda. It kinda is, you know. Because you want to know your background, you know. Sometimes it's good to know all that, but I don't know if all the time it's... I mean, it's really good to know a lot about that, but sometimes there's news that you don't want to hear. Like, someone died in your family, or someone humiliated someone else in your family. That's the bully at school now.
So you're schooled at home?
Yeah, I get to go to homeschool.
What's that like? What do you do?
Well, it's basically the same as a lot of schools. You know, you still got to do the work. You know, it's not all that in a bag of chips. You know, some people, you know, at those schools can be so rude. It was just like a book that I started writing, I think, like a while back or something. I was young. And I was going to make it, I mean, a lot of these characters I made up by kind of, like, adding them by wrestling characters. Like, belts and stuff that are in it. I think he's got, like, a beehive stuck on his head. I made it, it was like a while back when I wrote this. Uh-huh. And he has, like, this phony brother. It's not really his brother, but... he's, like, mentally retarded. And he was hiding in a garbage can with his brother. Well, at the time his name was Alvin, but they changed it to Calvin because when they were at a gas station, he took a sucker, and he thought he was going to be a fugitive or something, so he gave it to Calvin. I mean, wrestling's so fake, but you think when you grow up, they're going to, like, it's going to change a lot, like... there's going to be a lot more changes. It won't be fake, probably, and people will actually get hurt. Because in the future, a lot of people think that the world is getting better. The world actually is getting worse because it's getting better, but it's getting worse, you know, because people are, they're inventing things that are less pollution-like, but people are still, like, polluting and, you know, being ruthless and stuff. But, like, if a wrestling league, they'd probably even change, you know, fights to the death or something like that. There's a bunch of things that could change. The world is changing all the time, probably. No, it's not old-fashioned here. It's like, it's about the normal time here. I can't think of one thing here that's old-fashioned. But, there's houses, let's go back for a while to the person who invented a house. And there's a lot of things that go back a while. Your hat. Paperboys have been around for like who knows how long. If they were to get like something else, like a robot or someone, or even like these tubes that lead to their house, that'd be like weird for one thing. It'd be weird and it'd be boring. It'd be unexciting. It'd be just weird, I guess, if they had that. I think I was born when Ronald Reagan was around. I think I was alive when he was around, because I was born in 1987. He served like around 1983, was it, or something like that? But I don't know, he's kind of a good guy, I think. He's not that bad.
From Lord Jesus be our guest, let these gifts to us be blessed. By his hands we all are fed. Give us, Lord, our daily bread. Amen.
Okay. Well, I'll tell you what. We're going to be serving some beer, and it's awfully hot, so I'm going to pass it over here, Joe. Well, we start out with Andrew, and he was in a situation in which we had lost a lot of people in our family. There were a lot of deaths, and I felt at the time I couldn't figure it out, and he was pretty upset. So we thought, well, we'll just maybe move him to a new, you know, school environment. Maybe we'll see how that goes. So we did try a different school, and then we just, you know, he didn't really feel like he fit in or something. And so I said, well, why don't I just, you know, try homeschool? I'm a certified teacher, and I've heard a lot about it in the community.
Do you feel like your neighborhood is changing a lot?
Yes, very much. And it's, I would feel when I was growing up, there was maybe one person in our neighborhood divorced. And it was back then the scandal. I didn't understand what a scandal was, but I know when I asked my parents about it, they had said, shh, don't say anything. Now it's easier to talk about those things, and we all give each other support.
Foster, and that's my house, and I've had my paper out since last October, and these are my friends and my sister.
I would like to be a sports player, but I don't know.
What kind of sport?
Football or basketball.
Yeah.
Sure.
Hopefully I'll be ready and the eggs won't be cold, right? Okay, that's good.
I know, like when I had one, it was you have to have some responsibility because you have to be there to do it every day. And there's been a couple occasions where he's thought that you know, doing other things is a higher priority, and I've had to tell him papers come first. But it's been good.
I don't think people really get to know each other. And trust each other and know their neighbors as well as they should. Like he said, you know, I mean, it used to be I could go to the neighbors and hang out, you know, with this old neighbor couple and, you know, visit with them. And now you visit with a neighbor and you kind of worry about your kid. You know, you let your kids go to the neighbors and you're just not sure.
Yeah.
But it's because people don't stop and take the time to visit and find out who their neighbors are. And are you guys going to go play Nintendo or something then?
No, John.
Careful. Balancing act.
I got trophies, and these are from when I was in the Cub Scouts. These are Pinewood Derby trophies. I took third place 2 years in a row. This is my ball that I got signed for my team because we went undefeated and won our league championship. And this is my baseball trophy. Our team went undefeated and won the championship in that. Oh, this is my mom. She gave us all pictures, and I got this one. And here's a football medal.
What do you think we would lose if paper boys disappeared?
You'd lose the paper boy, but you still get the paper. But like off the internet or fax it. Something. I think there'll be like cars that are electronic, and there won't be any paper boys, and there'll be more like digital stuff, and it'll be more high tech.
Okay.
Brandon,
that was me. So, Mike, what do you think that future's gonna be like?
I don't really know. Well, not like my brother.
Not, well, kind of like
that
now.
That is scary. Yeah, I don't kid.
Not as bad violently, like people getting killed every day and people getting shot.
Okay.
Not as bad as this.
It's a video game.
Yeah.
Fake things instead of
hope it's not like this.
Driving around little go-karts. Yells at each other.
Yeah, keep deaking.
You got...
So who's your favorite athlete?
A ghost. Probably Michael Jordan.
Really? Still, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah? What's good about him?
He's really nice to, like, and he does movies and he plays different sports. He played baseball and basketball and he golfs. So you see him in, like, tournaments with celebrities.
Yeah. You watch TV?
Yeah.
What do you watch?
Mostly sports. It's all only me and my dad ever do.
Mike, he's gonna be doing my paper out when I'm gone. On vacation.
Why is he going with you?
So he can learn the route by the time I go. Okay. But knowing him, he probably won't learn it.
Why not?
Cause he goofs around.
Oh, what a...
Next one. Yep, and you can't be dropping the ads. Next one. I'll get the one on the left side. Mike, you got Fraser's house now.
The best thing about being a paper boy, it's your own thing. You're your own person, your own boss. You don't get that. I mean, kids can go off and work somewhere, but usually it's a fast food place or something like that, and you got other kids screwing around.
This is my room. It's right here in the middle, in the upper floor of my house. Once you get up the stairs, focal point, my entertainment center. Everything that's here I bought with my own money, made from my paper out. My favorite thing in here probably is like the 60, my cars up here. Collect these little model cars. Got a 66 Ferrari V12. It's like really cool. I think one of the coolest cars ever made. And then of course you got Mercedes and M-Class and 1991 Bugatti. A couple Ferraris here, a BMW Z3 Roadster, Porsche on either side. Probably some of my favorite cars ever, and I like cars a lot. And as you can see, I like entertainment and my electronics, my TV, and my 50+1 disc changer there, and my Nintendo Super Nintendo and my Nintendo 64. And my favorite movie ever is The Godfather. Hence the three Godfather movies right there. Like James Bond, 007 movie, the new one. Best video game, GoldenEye. Got that in my Nintendo 64. Of course, the all-time classic, Super Mario Brothers. Got to play that a lot. Other than that, there's nothing really here but my CDs. And as you can see, if you look around my walls, I got rap posters everywhere. So my Tupac posters, my Godfather poster, DMX. And then here, I made this about 5 or 6 months ago. It's a collage of, it's got Tupac and Snoop Dogg, Dr. Dre, Warren G, all in a big collage here. I got the preps, and that's kind of like me, and dressing in the, you know, polo shirts and whatnot, and then you got the druggies, and then they're just kind of always high or doing whatever they're doing, never really showing up to class much, and you have the geeks, which just sit and do homework all the day and nothing else, and then you have the goths who think the devil is cool and listen to Marilyn Manson and all that, and I think that's the four or five main groups there, and that's about it.
So tell me about what you guys want to be when you grow up in the future. Are you worried about it?
I'm going to go to culinary school and I'm going to own my own restaurant.
I want to be a rap superstar. Live large.
I want to see my cars.
And get more money.
I'm not really sure yet.
What do you want to do?
Engineer.
Engineer, yeah?
Yeah.
Cars. I'm a little rap. What do you
want to
do?
I want to manage a car wash.
This one right here will be a
Mr. Car Wash.
Two kids. Boy and a girl. House, probably, like I want to be a doctor, so a surgeon maybe, orthopedic surgeon or heart surgeon maybe, you know, some cardiovascular kind of surgery, but I want to be a surgeon. They make good money, seems like fun, it's an interesting field, you're helping people, which is good, and that way I could still have, like I said before, a couple Jaguars in the garage, and my one boy and my one girl, and a nice blonde wife. Blonde, brunette, whatever. I'd enjoy my job if I was a surgeon, but I'd definitely be there for the kids, my kids, and my family. Because when I was growing up, my real dad wasn't always there. Working and stuff, and I just want to remember that if I was working, I'd still have time for my kids.
Yeah.
So. This is a good job. It's a good job. Taught responsibility. Keeps me kind of floored sometimes. Keeps me on the ground because my friends are always like, "Oh, come on, let's go out to eat or go downtown." And I say, "Well, I want to, but you know, I got to do the paper out first." So. Best movie is The Godfather, and I don't know, it's just like a sense of kind of power, and he's just so powerful, and it's just, I mean, look at his face, he's just so cool. You're sitting there, and he's got The Godfather, and it just kind of amazes me. I find it kind of interesting, the whole mafia story about, you know, Al Capone, and it gives you a sense of how much power they really had. And how hard it was living the life that they did, and yet they did it anyway, and Godfather, oh, don't do this and kiss your little pinky ring. I mean, it's a cool kind of thought, kind of a fantasy world, but to think that it really happens, really neat. Okay, now these are just like real little cars, but they got lots of good detail. I like cars a lot, like, as you can probably tell, but I paid $1.99 for each of these cars. Isn't that good? I mean, that's like serious bargain hunting. And we got like the first Porsche Spyder here, and we got a couple Z3 BMW convertibles, the new Audi TT, which is a 2001 model, Mercedes-Benz CL class, obviously everyone likes that. I've got about 36 papers to deliver. The 37th one goes to my house. It usually takes me about 25 minutes on bike or 20 minutes on bike, depending on how hot it is, by myself. My fastest is 14, but that's when I have help from friends, so that's pretty good.
Can you time it?
I don't think anybody can do any better than 14 minutes. I don't think it's physically possible. Too much ground to cover.
me what your relationship with your dad was like and how you want it to change.
Well, I don't see him much. I talk to him daily, but things just didn't go well. When I was a kid, he was always gone working or doing something else, so it was tough. I was pretty much growing up with just my mom, so I didn't really have any influence from my dad as far as working on cars or tools or anything. I learned that all after I met my stepdad, pretty much. Before that, nothing like that really went on between us because he was always gone. But he was always working. I mean, not that he didn't provide, because that's what he was always out there to do, just to make more than enough money for the family. But
right.
I think I would have rather had him there than the money, you know?
Yeah.
So. It would just, I think it would really lose a sense of, it just brings like your neighbors together, you know, like as you're going along, and it's kind of an odd relationship, but yet a kind of special one. You're between your neighbors and your paper boy, and just knowing that I live in this neighborhood and I talk to them and they know me and I know them and I know where they live. It's kind of special. I mean, it's hard to explain, but I think we'd be losing kind of a way of connecting with each other in kind of a social manner. It's just kind of a social structure that's been around for so long. We're kind of losing something that keeps us connected as